Guys, it's Haff. I am back again, and this is part two of my revolution video. In part one, I unboxed the advent calendar that Revolution Beauty was selling via Priceline in Australia. Revolution is kind of new to Priceline, so they've got lots of interesting things. Some of the stuff I'm using in this video is from that particular video. A few things I got in the last Revolution Beauty that I unboxed, which was kind of their, like, it was like a Christmas gift box, had a whole bunch of palettes and a few other products in it. And I also bought a Revolution Beauty foundation and concealer. So I pretty much have a full face except for mascara. That's the only thing I don't have from Revolution. But I am going to be using a new mascara to see what I think of it. So I have already moisturised my skin. I'm going to go in with, it's not really the kind of primer I normally would use, but this is the Revolution Beauty's Mattifying Primer. This came in at the Vault type one that I unboxed a couple of weeks ago. This is a silicone primer. Haven't used it yet. First time using it. That's what it looks like. Just a normal clear silicone primer. So I'm basically just going to put that in the middle part of my face, because that's kind of the only place that gets any kind of oil, really. As I get older, my skin is just producing less oil, so So, the foundation, I got the Conceal and Hydrate because my skin's a little older. That's what it looks like. I got it in F1, which is clearly the lightest shade that they do that isn't. I think the next one up is more yellow. I have a almost blue undertone. One of the joys of being really pale is that quite often you end up kind of blue. Give it a shake. I have absolutely no idea what this is like. I've seen it used on other people's channels. Yeah, quite liquidy. I'm going to apply it first with my favourite fish brush, and then if I need to, I will blend it out with a sponge. I was going to say a beauty blender, but it's not a beauty blender. This is supposed to be medium to full coverage. Yeah. Okay, this goes a lot further than I was expecting. Probably only needed one pump. Because I still have some on the back of my hand, and I am a blank canvas. It doesn't feel heavy or anything like that. It's just very it's just got a lot of coverage, basically. Which is probably not my normal go-to, but not a lot of choice in Revlon Revolution Beauty's products, so just going to, using a sponge, you can kind of sheer a foundation out a little bit, make it not look quite so full on heavy if that isn't your jam. A brush is going to give you a heavier kind of coverage. I got really bad little creasy, wrinkly things right by my mouth. and makeup just settles into it. Like the lines on my forehead. Now, I don't have any Revolution powder to set this down, so I don't even know if it needs it. We will see. The other thing I don't have is, I do have, you know, I was going to say I don't have any brow products, but I do.
Hello, cruel world.
Oh, he just left a mark on my forehead. Good job.
Or was it you left a mark on my neck?
Probably a bit of both. So for concealer, I have the Conceal and Hydrate in C0.5, which comes with a massive doe foot applicator, which is frankly way bigger than anybody needs. Put that there. But yeah, it's massive. Blend that out with my damp sponge. Always end up with crusties. Now, this is not something that I normally do, but because I have it, I'm going to use some of this. We'll see what happens. It'll probably end up looking terrible. I'm not gonna lie. The Revolution baking powder. I would think a baking powder would be better if it came in a, like, loose powder form. But we'll just leave that on there for a bit. Okay, so brows. I'm going to use their little angled brushy thing in the vault, other one that I unboxed, with this, which is the eyebrow kit. So I'm going to start with this lightest shade here with the brush. Wow. It's quite ashy, which is not bad for an eyebrow powder. In most cases, you really don't want it to be too warm because it just looks weird. This is basically filling in what eyebrows I don't have. I have like big gaps in my eyebrows and they're really narrow because I come from the age when having plucked eyebrows was a thing. That's a pretty dark powder for somebody who is blonde, and that's the lightest shade that they have. So, yeah, you'd want to be, like, real careful. I'm not going to use the wax or anything. What I'm going to use is the brow gel that came in the advent calendar. It's just a little teeny tiny clear brow gel. Just to mostly just to brush through the brows and take off a bit of the product so it doesn't look quite so great. Okay. are going to do eyes. Now in the... Where did I put it? In the advent calendar, there is an eye primer. There's also one in the other box, one that I opened. I'm going to use this one. I'm going to zoom in so you can see what I'm doing to my eyes. Because I know Omnia loves it when I do that. So I'm going to apply a little bit of this eye primer to both eyelids. So this is like a nudie coloured one. Oops. Use my finger. So I've got a few choices of eyeshadow. I could use any one of the other palettes that I got, but I'm going to just stick with the ones that came in the advent calendar. So basically the palette I'm going to use is the Revolution Reloaded Fire palette. I'm going to start with this colour here. Just gonna put that all over the eyelid area. That's basically my skin tone. Then I'm gonna go into I'm going to go into this one here, which is a little bit darker. I'm going to take that fairly high above my crease area, not quite to my brow bone. Take that closer to the crease, not up as high. Make sure I blend it in. And I'm going to go into this one here. And be a bit more precise with where I put it. And take the brush I used before and give it a blend. Is ever so slightly damp, so it's kind of like not moving. then I'm going to take an even smaller brush. I'm just going to take the darkest brown. I'm just going to place that in the deepest part of the crease and on the outside corner. Then I'm going to take a flat shader brush and I am going to go into this goldy kind of colour right here. I'm going to put that on the bit of my eyelid that does not have any colour currently. And then I'm going to take the same flat shader brush and I'm going to go into the highlight that's in this palette that came out of the Vault thing. This is the Ultra Contour palette. I'm going to go into this one here and I'm going to put that on the brow bone. Because I don't have a liquid eyeliner from them. I'm just going to draw a line close to my lashes. So, if you don't have a liquid eyeliner, there's no reason why you can't use pencil eyeliner. Main reason people don't use pencil eyeliner as much anymore is because of the invention of liquid eyeliners, and liquid eyeliners tend to stay put a little bit better when they dry down, whereas pencils sort of remain somewhat blendable. Around too much, so but they're good if you just want a sort of a more smoky kind of eyeliner that's not as precise. Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to take that tiny angled brush from Revolution and I'm going to go into the sparkly black grey thingy that's in this mini palette that came in the advent calendar. And I'm going to press that over the eyeshadow. Over the pencil, sorry. And it's got a little bit of sparkle in it, so just adds a little bit of extra tight line with that black pencil as well. I'm going to do the bottom waterline as well because I have a feeling it's going to transfer anyway from my waterline. Didn't really get any fallout from the shadows. A little tiny bit, but nothing major. And now I am kind of yellow under my eyes. Which is not my favourite look. But there you go. I'm going to take my little pointy brush that I was using before. And I'm going to go into this one here in the middle. I'm going to blend that. And my lower lash line. And the mascara that I'm going to use today is What's Your Type from the Balm, which John McLean is always talking about. It's his favourite mascara. I managed to find it. It's actually kind of difficult to get hold of. That's what it looks like. It's a black tube. It has quite a narrow wand on it, but it's also irregular bristles, like they're not regular bristles. Right, I'm going to zoom out and do the rest of my makeup. I'm going to do a tiny bit of contour because I have this contour palette from Revolution. I'm going to use that middle shade because it's the lightest one. I don't normally bronze either because I have a new bronzer, if I can find it. I'll do a tiny bit of bronzing, being ultra careful. I don't think this foundation sets down. Probably a tiny bit. Calendar, which doesn't have a name. Okay, we have contour. Highlighters. I have three to choose from. I think I'm going to go with the slightly pinky baked one. Okay. Let's try the champagne one. This one is a pressed one instead. Slightly better. Not exactly a blinding highlight. More subtle. Mascara, because it's dried now. This kind of gives you fairly long, thin-ish lashes, like they're not like super thick, which I don't mind at all. I'd rather they be long and thin than short and fat. So I am, before I put on any lipstick, I'm going to use the cooling fixing spray that came in the vault thing. I don't like the smell of that, and I don't like the sprayer. The sprayer is pretty naff. If you're wondering what it smells like alcohol. So for lipstick, I'm going to line my lips first with Schiffer, which came in the advent calendar. And then I'm going to use the liquid lipstick that came in the advent calendar, which is bright red. It's also matte and it does set down, because it set down on the back of my hand. almost full face of Revolution Beauty products. On the whole, I liked all of them except the fixing spray, which I don't like the smell of at all. It appears to have set down the makeup. I don't know how well it'll make it stay or anything. So far, I am pretty happy with all of those. So this is kind of like a first impressions as well. I love this lip colour. It's probably a little bit too pink for the eye look. It's not an orangey red, but it's kind of making my teeth look a bit yellow. But not that they're not already yellow. So that is it for this video. If you want to subscribe, click the button down there, click the little bell if you want to get notified of when I upload new content. Leave me a thumbs up if you like makeup type videos, and leave me a comment down below. I try to respond to all questions that are asked, but I will at least like your comment. And I will see you in my next video. See ya.